Hey everyone, welcome to Gun Haven. My name's Aaron, and today, guys, we're looking at the first review of the channel. We're getting started right now. Hey everyone, welcome back to Gun Haven. Today's video, guys, we are going to be reviewing the Tanfoglio Witness 1911 BB pistol. This is going to be the review, and I will be uploading the field test next time I upload. But today, guys, we're going to focus on the specifications of this gun and focus on some of the things and the key features about this gun. And while you're here, why not consider subscribing so you never miss any content? And without further ado, let's get into the specifications. So, guys, general disclaimer here, this magazine has been unloaded and the gun is on safe, and it will remain that way for the entire video. So let's look at the specifications here. I did write them down to keep them organized so I can look off them. This gun is a 177 4.5 steel millimeter BB gun. So this is a BB gun, takes, you know, 177 BB.
This BB gun has a weight of about 2 pounds and a overall length of about 9 inches.
This is a smooth bore BB gun, meaning the, you know, the bore inside is, the barrel is, you know, smooth. It's not a rifle barrel like you'd find on a, you know, a rifle or something. It's a smooth bore. This gun does have a beaver tail safety right here. We're gonna flip the gun around here. This gun is manufactured by Cybergun and KWC, I think is how that is. Cybergun and KWC. You guys can see that right there, Tanfoglio Witness. You got the markings on here. Obviously, this is based off the Colt 1911. A few general more specifications here. This is single action only, and this is a full blowback BB gun, meaning, you know, it's not a half or, you know, fixed. It is a full blowback. So it does have some fixed sights in the front and the back, so you have to get a little closer and see detail. You got fixed front sight, and you got fixed rear sight here, and obviously got the hammer right back here. You obviously got this, you know, you got a full trigger. You don't got a, you know, skeletalized trigger. You know, you got the full trigger. It does get a FPS of about 320, I think is what it is. I haven't actually tested this yet. We got a single action only, meaning the gun does have to be, you know, once the hammer is, you know, like this, the gun has to be, you know, cocked in order to, you know, be able to shoot the gun. So single action. It is powered by a 12-gram CO2 cartridge, which is housed in the full metal magazine. It feels full metal to me. Maybe a few parts on here that are not metal, but for the most part, metal. It is 18 shots, and it is fully detachable, meaning it can go in, and it can come out. So that's for the general specifications, I would say, and we're going to go ahead and move on to maybe some pros and cons about this gun, and, you know, what I recommend to use with this gun. All right, everyone, I recommend using Daisy BBs with this gun. I don't know, they just work a lot better for some reason. They do work a lot better than the Crosman. I haven't even tried the Crosman. This does work okay with Crosman CO2. They seem to fit pretty nice. I've never had a problem using Crosman CO2. For the oil-wise, I wouldn't know. You know, I'm not sure what you should use. You know, I thought maybe pellet gun oil, but see, I don't know what the seal exactly made out of, so... You know, I don't know whether to use RM coils, so that will be something that, you know, you guys can let me know if you guys do know. So, everyone, we're going to go ahead and talk about a few pros and cons here. So, this gun is very realistic. That is one pro. I own a Colt Commander 1911, and, you know, it feels very realistic. You know, I did used to own a real, you know, Tanfoglio Witness, you know, 9mm, you know, and it's very realistic, you know, very realistic weight. You know, I really like the realism of this gun. You know, every time you... go to aim it, you know, you just really feel some realism there with this gun. So that's a pro. Another pro is obviously CO2 usage is about, you know, I want to say between 4 and 6 magazines in the summer. So, you know, in the winter, I don't know, I haven't shot this gun yet in the winter, but, you know, figure it out, you know, over the field test video that I'll be posting on Thursday. But, you know, this gun obviously does get some good CO2 usage. Another pro about this gun, you know, is it is, you know, pretty accurate. You know, I do have to say that, you know, with the fixed sights, you know, very, very accurate. I do have to say that, you know, very, very, very accurate. You know, you can shoot pretty much in the center, you know, of any target. And, you know, you don't have to be the best shot, or, you know, you don't have to be a, you know, competitive, you know, you don't have to be in, you know, competition shooting, you know, to get, you know, place some good shots downrange with this. Couple cons I have to say with this is, obviously, you know, sometimes you know, feels a little bit loose sometimes, you know, maybe not that much, but, you know, also is this mark right here. I don't know if it just got that over time, but, you know, there is a little paint coming off there. That is a con about this gun. So everyone, I hope you guys enjoyed this review. If you did, make sure you guys leave a quick like and maybe possibly subscribing for more air gun content. On Thursday, I will be posting a field test video, which we will be shooting the gun and field testing it and giving it an overall rating. And if you guys did enjoy this video, I'll have a link in the description for the tips for safe shooting. And I will also have a link for this gun where you can purchase this gun at on, you know, give you guys a link where you guys can buy it at, you know, maybe check this out for yourself. And I hope to see you guys all soon, and stay safe, and make sure you guys check out Safe Tips for Shooting. It's Air Gun Safety 101.